Hey guys, it's Nate from the Bike Company. I want to take a minute and show you how to change volume spacers on an Ohlins TTX, like the one on this Mondraker FOXY. Now, this is a little different than everything I've ever ridden before, which is when you air this shock down, it actually collapses with some pretty notable force. I'm going to show you an outtake of me doing it in the shop on my bike, where I use a three-way to air it down, and it actually grabs and pinches it into the frame. You know, I kind of had always been a person who would air down shocks in the frame before I did service to make sure that I didn't forget and end up having a detonation. But with this particular shock, I'm just going to remember to air it down in the vise because it collapses, like I said, with enough force that it took me prying on the back end to get the tool out so I could remove everything. So it's kind of a funny little video. So with this shock, it's a little bit different than some of the shocks that I've worked with in the last few years. This is what's called a double air sleeve shock. And you can tell there's two models of TTX. One is a mono air sleeve, and you open that with a strap wrench. This one you're gonna actually open with a bottom bracket tool, and it's an outer can kind of threaded onto an inner section. What was different for me on this, you know, speaking from a marketing brand development person, not a mechanic who's gonna be like, yeah, of course, that's how Ohlins works. The air down caught me a little bit off guard because on my previous shocks, if you had a shock that was stuck down, it was theoretically a pretty good problem based on the negative air chamber maintaining a charge, and you were gonna have to be real careful when you released that. So even though I'd watched the how-to from Ohlins, which was great, and I even did the twirl with the wrench just like he did, I still, when it actually sucked down, I got nervous and went and grabbed one of my mechanics and, hey, I'm doing this correct. And we sort of looked at it and, yeah, it just needed to be threaded off further. So you're gonna see threaded all the way off, and then I'm able to get at the air volume spacers. There's two different types of air volume spacers in this shock. I've got the band kind in between the double air can, and I've got a puck kind at the end of the shock as well. So I went onto Ohlins' site and I figured out how many volume spacers this shock could run. And then I went back and figured out what was in it so I could decide what I wanted to add. So in its stock configuration, this shock had two of the bands and a 12,000 cubic millimeter volume spacer. The bands are each 2,000 cubic millimeters. So I went and I found the part number, looked at Ohlins' chart, and figured out, okay, well, I could add two more bands to max out the ramp on this shock. And that's what I went ahead and did. So there's a variety of ways you can get to the number you want to get to with these Ohlins shocks, with a combination of the bands as well as the internal pucks. So a lot of options on how to adjust it. This is how I did mine. I'm looking for the most ramp to test it at this point. So to put it back together, you make sure that the tab lines up on the outer can, and then thread the system back together, air it up. Go make sure it holds air properly, bounce it around in the parking lot, and I'm gonna wait for it to cool down just a little bit. I'm gonna sneak out and ride it with the max volume spacers and see how that ramp rate is affected.